next thing that we need to consider before we get scanning is the way that we're dressed and the environment that we're in. So looking at actually getting ourselves ready, we need to make sure that we remove any jewelry, including watches and rings. And put them in a safe place. Next, we need to make sure that we tie our hair back for the ladies. And get it out of the way. Then we need to make sure that we have appropriate clothing on. So in this case, I'm wearing a boiler suit or coveralls. I'm also wearing waterproof trousers. And I'm also wearing welly boots. Now we can start to, in this particular instance with the machine that we're using, we can put it on as it sits on our hip. So we want to ensure that this stays as dry as possible. Obviously, the probe will be going inside the cow, but we need to protect the console if possible while ensuring that we keep the buttons, which will control our frequency, our depth, and our gain, accessible to us throughout the scanning period. We have a carry case. And we clip that in. Next, we'll go ahead and put the scanner on and then make some adjustments. Just as a note, remember to always hold the face of the probe in the palm of your hand so it doesn't knock against any gates and become damaged. I will be scanning right-handed, so I will wear this actually on the left side of my body so that I can control the buttons. If you're using a stationary machine, just make sure that it's out of the flow of traffic and footfall of the cows to ensure it doesn't get knocked over and damaged. But you also need to be able to see the screen without having to crane your neck too much, especially if you're doing a large volume of cows. So now we will put on a waterproof top, which will protect the console and also enable us to have faster cleanup, because we can actually feed the cable of the probe up and through the sleeve of our waterproof top. What this will allow us to do as well is to ensure that this end of the probe with the crystals is kept as close to our body as possible so that it won't become damaged. Palm the probe to ensure that the face doesn't get damaged. Now, we have our waterproof top, we've covered over the console, and we're at less risk of the ultrasound probe flapping around and potentially becoming damaged. Now we're ready to go and prepare our cows. Now we need to look at the environment that we have set up for scanning. Those will largely depend on the farm that you're actually working at. This particular farm at Bristol University has dedicated purpose-built facilities, which actually makes handling very easy. But what you mainly need to bear in mind is personal safety, and also safety of the cows and the other staff members wherever you're working. In this particular facility, we actually have dedicated stocks, or AI stalls, where each cow can slot in individually, and we have good access to be able to perform our examination. You can also use locking head yokes or individual crush or stock facilities. As previously discussed, we do need to have some form of actually viewing the image. In this particular case, with this machine, what we'll be using is a set of goggles that actually shows us the image right before our eyes. So we'll just put those on now. What these goggles will allow us to do is actually view the ultrasound image while retaining our peripheral vision. This is important in a farm environment to ensure against safety. If you're using a stationary machine with a monitor, just make sure, again, that it's out of the primary footfall of people and cows, and that you are able to visualize it at all times without having to twist your body or crane your neck.